if anyone obeys his word, God's love is truly made complete in him. This is how we know we are in him. Whoever claims to live in him must walk as Jesus did. When we are together, when we're faithful together, when we serve together, the power in that. And I wanted to invite another person up, Chris. Chris and I met about, you know, maybe about 5 or 6 or 7 years ago, I don't know. And Chris was living in Miami area. And I was like, man, there's a part of me that would love for the church to hear this, because I think it really gets at what we're trying to talk about.
I was working in the ministry at the time, youth and family ministry, and I had one of my one of the teens that I mentored with me, a kid named Tommy, and we went to a McDonald's after some event. And the event, we had a whole bunch of what they call in Miami pastelitos, which are little like guava and cheese and little croquetas and different types of pastries. Tommy and I were eating there. I felt someone kind of like over the partition, kind of staring onto where our table was, and I was kind of uncomfortable, and we didn't know if he was gonna fight or what was gonna happen. And so Tommy noticed that he was looking at our little pastelitos there, and so we were like, would you like one? He's like, yeah, please. Gave him one, and all right, leave us alone, you know, we're just trying, you know, trying to get engaged. I was very like self-focused, right? Sometimes, you know, Melody talked about just kind of listening to the Spirit's prompting. Well, at the moment I was just trying to not be bothered. Well, kept looking over again. So we're like, would you like some more? So we gave him some more, started having a conversation, found out he was homeless. And I'd never seen someone this young living on the street. And he had been sleeping in the slide that has the enclosures so he didn't get wet when it rained. Met with him later on and found out his backstory. Apparently his father had left him when he was young, and he had a stepfather and his mom who were abusive. To the point where around 9 or 10 years old, the stepfather broke one of his arms. He had to walk to the hospital for about 2 miles on his own. Of course, they called child services, arrested the stepfather, took away the mom, took him into foster care program, and then he aged out and was on his own on the street. And you know what happens on the street is, you know, the drugs and the exposure to crime and just the bad cycles. This was, God is like the star of the show. When he put us there in that McDonald's, I got to a point where I was like, I need to help him. You know, this is what we do. So, you know, brought him over to the house, talked to my wife. We just had our daughter. And I said, hey, can he stay here in our home overnight? She was like, yeah, for sure. So he stayed in our home. Let him take a shower, went out, bought him all new, you know, the clothes and the thing, toiletries, things that he needed. And then we got on the computer because he needed to get his GED and his Florida identification just so that he can get back on his feet so he can get a job. Got a job working, I think it was at Wendy's down there. Came out to church. His first view of the church was judgmental. I mean, he was so hardened, he didn't expect grace or kindness to be offered to him or even have someone bring him in their home. And a couple brothers pulled some money together, bought him a bus ticket because he had a job waiting for him with for family members out in the Midwest. And I kept in touch with him all these years, and now he's a dad. He's got his own son. And so it's just amazing how God puts us in situations and just kind of expects us or hopes that we'll be faithful. Reminds me of that story where Jesus had the 10 that he healed, the 10 lepers, and only one came back.
Yeah.
I mean, the 9 that didn't say thank you were still healed.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? And who knows what happened to their lives later on down the road. I think, you know, in reality, that I think for him, where he was coming from, he did express gratitude. He did call me a ton. There were moments later on where I think, you know, when you give somebody who hasn't had much and you give to them, there's the concern of like, is it going to be like this ongoing thing for years and I'm going to be like codependently feeding him and not really helping him. Overarchingly, God will plant a seed in someone, even if it's the toughest soil, and who knows years later when that'll blossom into something that's glorious.
Amen.